Sembele ma di ma ai tamo kapobe Omo fara foba mone wando ya monyo Sembele ma di ma ai tamo kapotwese Omo fara foba mone wando ya monyo Sembele ma di ma ai tamo kapotwese Omo fara foba mone wando ya monyo Kwaputu atu monokia Imamu Angola, wafulu mwenyo, mwenye, ni makutuwe. Watono kakia, ni kuzwe lake. Sembele madima, ikamu kaputuweze, kumu farafuba, mwene wando ya mwenyo. Sembele madima, waikamu kaputuweze, kumu farafuba, mwene wando ya mwenyo. Sembele madima, ikamu kaputuweze, kumu farafuba, mwene wando ya mwenyo. Sembele madima, ikamu kaputuweze, kumu farafuba, mwene wando ya mwenyo. Kwaputu atumonokia Imamu Angola Wafulu mwenyo Mwenye ni makutuwe Watono kakia Nikuzelake Sembele madima, ikamu kaputuweze, kumu farafuba, mwene wando ya mwenyo. Sembele madima, ikamu kaputuweze, kumu farafuba, mwene wando ya mwenyo. Sembele madima, ikamu kaputuweze, kumu farafuba, mwene wando ya mwenyo. Sembele madima, ikamu kaputuweze, kumu farafuba, mwene wando ya mwenyo.
Great to be back physically in the K-Squid studio. And I saw the new renovations and everything. It looks great. You're joining us for a very special Sunday dinner this evening. I'm going to be playing a lot of music tonight, whereas most shows are really dialogue heavy. This show is going to be very music heavy. It's dedicated to my mother, who passed away, transitioned on, crossed over into the other plane back in February, and she used to have a radio show back in the early 1990s, and so we're going to share some stories, some memories, funny stories about my mother, Marcy, but that's going to be sandwiched with some music that is reminiscent of the type of music she used to play on her radio show. So the songs may have a connection to the conversation in some way if you find it, but mainly the music is just thematic in the sense of this is the kind of music I would hear as a little kid in the radio station listening to her do her show. So thank you for joining us for this very special episode. So we're going to get started by jumping right into some of that music, and our first selection for us will be Mornin' by Al Jarreau, and then we'll have another selection and we'll be back.
Everything is fine in my mind. everything here is just fine. In my mind. Excuse me if I sing. My heart has found its wings. Searching high and low. And now at last I know.
Search for the time on a watch with no hand.
Welcome, welcome back, everyone. If you're just tuning in, you're listening to the Sunday Dinner on K-Squid 90.7 FM, 89.5 FM, and 89.7 FM KSQT Prunedale. You also may be streaming live at ksqd.org, especially if you're DJ Cold T. Shout out. I know you couldn't join me this evening, but I know you're out there listening at some point, so I'm going to give a shout out to you. You're streaming at ksqd.org, and if you are, you're super cool. Even if you're not DJ Cold T, you're super cool if you're streaming live online. So welcome back. And if you're again just tuning in, you just heard Morning by Al Jarreau off the album Jarreau, and you just heard These Dreams by Heart off the album Heart. And so for this show, we're going to be dedicating it pretty much to my mother, Marcy, who had a radio show back in the Akron-Canton area, Northeast Ohio, in the early 1990s. And so I'm going to be playing some of the music that's reminiscent of what she would play and what I would hear growing up as a kid. So it's very, like, you know, easy listening, soft rock, quiet storm kind of vibes. And in between that, I'll be sharing some memories and some stories. And so right now we're going to do a little bit of that. And so I'm going to start this first course of our Sunday dinner this evening with some life lessons from Marcy. All right, some life lessons. In no particular order, I just picked some that stood out to me. Preface by saying I tried to remember as much as I could about her radio show. The closest memories that would come back was just the music. So now I'm going to be on this journey to see how, when, where I find these little nuggets from the past, right, to get at, anyone who might be listening out there, right, who might happen to know, okay, oh yeah, I used to listen to, you know, this show in Northeast Ohio in the early 90s, and that sounds kind of familiar. I don't know, between now and the rest of my life, who knows, I'll be piecing these memories together. Her radio show played this kind of music, and she was just an amazing DJ. She had a great radio voice. So if you're sitting there thinking, oh, DJ Dupsie, you have a nice radio voice, well, thank you. I didn't get it by myself. I got it from my mother. Her radio voice was definitely one that folks spoke to and complimented and praised. So first life lesson from Marcy: you can't control someone and try to have a relationship with them at the same time, right? Let that marinate. And so usually I don't like to operate in absolutes or dichotomies, but this is one of those ones, you know, that my mom would say sometimes, and it really stuck with me, right, in thinking about how you foster and develop a relationship with someone, and how usually the traits of relationships that are toxic are unhealthy. There's some element of control, right? Someone's trying to control another person, or, you know, the situation or the way they think or something like that. And so at some point in my life, you know, watching my mother navigate our familiar relationships and other relationships in her life, one of the conclusions she came to was, yeah, it's hard to have a relationship with someone and control them at the same time. And that rings true with other kind of idioms we hear, adages like, you know, if you love something or love someone, let it go, right? Something like that. And so that kind of gets at that, right? That you can't control someone and have a relationship with them at the same time. And that's definitely, stuck with me and has, you know, been an influence in how I approach any kind of relationship, right? Whether it's platonic, romantic, you know, vocational, professional relationships, right? It's how do I get to know someone? How do I, you know, ask, you know, someone to work with me, even in a situation where I'm the quote unquote supervisor, because even I don't like those dynamics, right? And what I always tell my staff is that, like, I'm not telling you to do anything. I'm asking you, right? As part of this work that we all signed up to do, right? Hopefully we have, you know, something that's keeping us here and some deeper meaning. And so I never want to try to lead a situation like that in that situation through control or through fear, right? Which is what we see a lot of, unfortunately, in our working world and in our working lives, is that, you know, there's a lot of fear and control used in those spaces, and it's not healthy. So thinking about how we can also reimagine that space, that if we do want to people to be productive, whatever that means, I don't like that word either, but if we want people to be productive, whatever that means, then how can we approach that from a more relational framework, rather than, you know, you jump when I say how, you know, or when I say jump, you say how high, you know. So yeah, can't control someone and try to have a relationship with them at the same time. next, and this is not to implicate anyone in this room, in this booth, or working at the station, but this is what Marcy would used to say: technology takes on the characteristics of its users and owners. And she would usually say that in the context of when her laptop wouldn't turn on or was on the fritz. So again, not to implicate anyone in this room or anyone in the K-Squid family. I swear my mom used to say this a long time ago. But I think underneath those words, right? Underneath those words is this idea that, you know, as we evolve, and especially, you know, as the conversations around AI are starting to really heat up and ramp up, I think underneath those words, what she meant was that, you know, we as humans, we have a responsibility in the technology that we produce and create and evolve. And that, you know, we can't do this thing where it's like, you know, oh, AI, you know, we just give it this and then it does its own thing. And then whatever happens, we just blame AI. It's like, no, we have a responsibility in as the creators, right, as the progenitors, whatever you want to call it, you know, our human stuff is going to be wrapped up in all of that. If this is something that's coming from our imagination, from our brain power, then our own stuff is going to be wrapped up in it. It's almost like a child. It's almost like having a child, right? You can't, have a child and then like just completely separate yourself and then no, that child has nothing to do with me. No, that child has your DNA, right? It has your genetics. And so just like AI is going to have our human genetics in it somewhere. And so when we say technology takes on the characteristics of its users and owners, that's what I think. That's what I take from it in terms of that, is that we have a responsibility in our technological evolution remember that there are a lot of other elements that keep an ecosystem in balance, and that AI is not going to be any one panacea, you know, solve all, cure all solution. It's going to need to be a part of an ecosystem. But if we're setting it up to be something that takes over, well, then, you know, we're going to self-fulfilling prophecy, that apocalypse that some people are worried about with the onset of AI. So, just remember that technology takes on the characteristics of its users and its owners. We can't separate our human stuff from the technology that we create. And lastly, in this first course, another lesson that I took from Marcy, of course, there are much, much more, many, many more, but I only have an hour show. So the universe will take care of people much better than I can. Now, I know that sounds ominous, and in some cases, you know, it is kind of a karmic kind of thing. And I think more broadly, right, it just means, I think it kind of also goes back to that control thing that I mentioned at the beginning, right, that, you know, we can't try to control how people feel, right? We can't control how other people respond to things. We can only control how we do that. And in terms of, like, you know, if we want someone to feel some kind of thing, or if revenge or vengeance is on the table, right, and we want somebody to feel hurt because we got hurt, you know, that's a real thing. And for a lot of reasons in this world, you know, a lot of people feel that way. And so that's not for me to judge or, you know, analyze that feeling one way or the other. What I've learned, again, just the lessons that Marcy has taught me, when it comes to that, right, when it comes to that conflict, and, like, you know, why does it seem that, you know, bad people get away with, you know, doing, or, yeah, bad people get away with doing bad things, quote unquote. It's that, yeah, that energy, right, that we put out there, will come back to us, right? And so sometimes my mother would say, you know, the Lord, right, being of Christian faith. So I just broaden it to say the universe, right? So no matter what your faith or not, thinking about, you know, this idea that there's an exchange, right, that what I put out there comes back to me in some way, shape, or form, and that when it comes to, yeah, trying to make somebody feel something because I felt it and I want them to feel the exact same way that I felt, it's hard to do that. But the universe can do that, right? Through just situations and how life unfolds, and how it just takes people through different experiences, takes us through different experiences. Eventually everyone will have that kind of universal experience, right? Of being up, being down, being in the middle, and everything in between. So yeah, just some life lessons from Marcy that I wanted to share with y'all. Again, in no particular order, right? And so as we wrap up our first course, we'll close it with a couple more songs. And then we'll come back for our second course. And again, if you're just tuning in, you're listening to the Sunday Dinner on 90.7 K-Squid. You're also listening on 89.5 FM or 89.7 FM, KSQT Prunedale, or you might be streaming on live at ksqd.org. Keep it tuned as we get back into some tunes.
Just
If you're just now tuning in, you're listening to The Sunday Dinner, a very special episode of The Sunday Dinner, where yours truly, DJ Dupsie, is dedicating this episode to my mother, Marcy, who recently transitioned over into the spirit plane back in February of this year. The music you're hearing is reminiscent of the type of music that she would play on her radio show back in the early 90s in Northeast Ohio, the Akron-Canton, Ohio area, just in case anyone's listening from out there, shout out. So you're basically listening to the kind of music that, or some of the kind of music that I grew up on, grown folks music, if you will. And so certainly now listening back as an adult, a lot of these songs hit very differently. But as a kid, they just sounded really nice, or they had a nice melody, or like, you know, the singer. But now listening back to them as an adult, they definitely take on some meaning after you go through some stuff. And so to open up our second course, we're going to get back into some music. But first, you heard I Just Want to Stop by Gino Vannelli off his album Brother to Brother. And then after that, you heard Piano in the Dark by Brenda Russell off her album Get Here. And so we're going to open up our second course with some more music. And then we're going to share some funny stories about my mother that I remember and that are radio friendly. So we'll get into our first song of the second course, Time Out of Mind by Steely Dan.
Thank you.
Welcome back to the Sunday Dinner, a very special episode of the Sunday Dinner where we're dedicating it to the music that my mom used to play on her radio show back in the early 90s. If you're just tuning in, you're listening on K-Squid 90.7 FM, 89.5 FM, and 89.7 FM KSQT Prunedale. You may also be streaming live at ksqd.org. And if you are my friend, buddy DJ Cole T, who was going to join me tonight but couldn't, had some other stuff come up, life is life. Giving you a shout out just in case you're listening now, streaming at ksqd.org. Those song selections that you just heard, Time Out of Mind by Steely Dan from their album Gaucho, and you just heard Same Old Love by Anita Baker from her amazing album Rapture. And again, these songs are reminiscent of the type of music that my mom would play on her radio show back in the early 90s. And so some of the songs might have a connection to some of the stories and memories I'm sharing. Some might not. And so if you find some of those connections, great. But this is definitely just a pastiche of memories and music from my childhood that I would hear growing up. And so for the second course, I just have a couple funny stories that I want to share, because one of the things that my mom is known for is her sense of humor. And notice how I'm saying is, because one of the things that I have dedicated myself to doing is that when I talk about her, to talk about her in the present tense, because she is not gone, she is still with me. She will be mothering me for the rest of my life, and her life lessons and her funny memories will guide me for the rest of my days. So, first funny story, in no particular order. it's Father's Day, so, you know, start with a Mother's Day story, you know, and even though it's not father related, but it's a parent's day. So we'll start with that. And I remember we were in a grocery store, our local grocery store, and we were looking at Mother's Day cards. And I guess, long story short, my mother and her mother, my grandmother, their relationship, not going to put all my family business out there on the national airwaves, but I'm sure some folks can relate, you know, parents, relationships, family stuff, family mess, we all have it. And so we were looking at Mother's Day cards, and there was this Mother's Day card of some kid sitting on a toilet. We forgot what it said, but we just liked that visual of a kid sitting on a toilet, and me and my mom are whispering to ourselves. We're just going back and forth, making little jokes, and we're like, yeah, happy Mother's Day, because you're full of crap. Thinking about giving this card to my grandmother, who, you know, of course, it would have been unthinkable. But we were just having fun. We were just playing pretend. But this woman, total stranger that we didn't know, was standing, like, you know, kind of next to us down the aisle a little bit, overheard us, you know, talking about, you know, my grandmother, her mother, and this card that we want to get her, this, you know, happy Mother's Day because you're full of crap. And she just starts laughing, and we're like, oh my goodness, you know. We didn't realize how loud we were being and sharing our family business out there, but she happened to relate. She was like, yeah, you know, sometimes that's, you know, that's how you feel. And, you know, sometimes we wish we had cards that, you know, so I'm sure there are people out there that make those kind of cards. But at the time, you know, we were just going to the store. So, you know, we didn't know where to get, you know, little cards like that. And plus, like I said, I don't think my grandmother, her sense of humor would appreciate that. But me and my mom and the total stranger in the card aisle in the store got a great laugh out of it that day. So yeah, I'm not sure. I can't even remember again what the card actually said, but it had a picture of a little kid sitting on the toilet. So from there, we just took off with the jokes. Next funny story that I can remember, and of course some of these, you know, you might have had to been there. They may not be, you know, ha ha ha, you know, laugh out loud funny, but then again, I'm not a stand-up comedian. I'm not billing myself as one. These are just humorous memories to share with you, and hopefully they connect and relate. So I went to visit the college that I went to, that I chose for undergrad, and it was one of those, you know, you go visit the campus beforehand on your own, and sometimes, you know, there's a lot of guided tours and stuff, but we just decided to go in the evening, go on our own, and just go exploring. And, you know, firstly, you know, had a little episode at the rest stop where we had a rental car. We're trying to figure out how to work it, and we're trying to, you know, get back on the road, and we're trying to use a little fob to unlock the door. But everything is unlocking except the door, right? And so the car alarm's going off, the trunk's popping open, all this, you know, business is going on with car making noise, and we're trying to get back in the car and just make it to campus. And so we eventually make it to campus, but then it's nighttime, and so we're driving on the sidewalk of the campus because we can't see where we're going. And so we're literally driving. If this was the middle of the day, this would have been like one of the main quads that people walk through to get to class. But because it was at night, no one was there, but it seemed like a road. It was, you know, how colleges have those wide sidewalks. It looked like a street, so my mom just pulled on up into it, and after a while I was like, I think we're on a sidewalk. She's like, no, we're not. So that was an episode. And lastly, real quick, I'll just share. So close out our second course, get you back into the music. My mom went to one high school football game as part of the marching band boosters, parent boosters, whatever. I was in the marching band for 2 years, my last 2 years in high school. And so she went on one band trip my junior year in high school, one toward the beginning of the year. She got on the bus, and it happened to be the game with our arch rival. And so we were singing a bunch of songs, and it wasn't your typical, you know, band trip to an away game, right? Because we were singing a bunch of songs because it was our rival. She proceeded to act a fool and take the words to the songs we were singing and make them totally inappropriate. We were maybe singing PG-13, right, kind of lyrics to these fight songs. She definitely turned them rated R. And that one trip, that one night, that one bus ride to and from our away game, my friends remembered for the next 2 years, right? And they would come up and ask me a year later, hey Mark, when's your mom coming back to a game? We still remember when your mom came to that game, and she was acting out, she was wilding out, when's she coming back? Even after high school, like a few years after high school, when I would come back, oh man, we still remember when your mom came to that football game, she was acting a fool on the bus. Yep, I'm sure you do, because that is, you know, what she would do. And I've been known to do that, apparently. So we're closing out the second course with some funny memories, and we're going to get you back into some good music. We're feeding you tonight on the Sunday Dinner with some good, good music. Again, very music-heavy show and reminiscent of the songs that my mother would play. So we'll close out the second course with a few more selections, and then we'll close out with our Just Desserts.
Started of you thinking that I had been untrue. But if you think that we'd be better parted, it's gonna hurt me, but I break away from you. Well, just give me the sign.
Just
welcome back to the Sunday Dinner, a very special episode of the Sunday Dinner. You're listening on 90.7 FM, 89.5 FM KSQD, and 89.7 FM KSQT Prunedale, and you're also streaming live at KSQD.org. Once again, I'm DJ Dupsie, and this special episode of the Sunday Dinner has been a healthy serving of some wonderful music from my childhood that I would grow up listening to, that my mother would play on her radio station in the early 90s back in the Akron Canton area in Northeast Ohio. And so thank you for coming along this journey with me. The songs that you just heard were How Much I Feel by Ambrosia from their album Life Beyond LA, and you just heard Devotion by Earth, Wind & Fire from their album Open Your Eyes. Again, feeding you good music, music for the soul here on the Sunday Dinner. And so closing just with some last words about my mother. And of course, this won't be the last time, right? She comes up in discussion, dialogue, right? As life goes on, this will be about sharing her stories and sharing her memories and seeing if me and Eliza here can do some investigative work to see if we can tap some of her connections in Northeast Ohio around that time to see if anyone might remember. So that'll be fun as well. And so we're going to close out our Just Desserts talking about Marcy's sweetness. Marcy was a very sweet person, is a very sweet person, is a very sweet mother. Again, her sense of humor was very infectious and very mischievous a lot of the times, but always making people laugh and always trying to lift people's spirits. And that's one of the things that people reflected a lot at her homegoing services, is how sweet and how funny she is. And her favorite all-time singer, hands down, bar none, is Chaka Khan. And so we're going to close out this very special episode of the Sunday Dinner and our Just Desserts, of course, with Sweet Thing for our Just Desserts to close out this very special episode of the Sunday Dinner. Thank you so much for tuning in. Please tune in our summer season for July and August. We're hopefully going to get some familiar voices back in here. But again, it's great to be back here physically in the studio with y'all. I'm back in the K-Squid family. And so, we're going to close out this very special episode of the Sunday Dinner dedicated to my mother, Marcy, with Sweet Thing by Rufus and Chaka Khan from their album Rufus.
Just won't.